Hi guys, this is your super user. Here I am back with another mid-range smartphone. This time it's much hyped OnePlus Nord. Let's see what OnePlus has to offer us this time. Before we start, do hit the like button below if you like this video. I'll insist you guys to subscribe to your super user. If you still haven't, hit that subscribe button and also press the bell icon to not miss any updates. So here we have OnePlus box, OnePlus branding on the side. We have got a top end model, 256GB internal and 12GB RAM variant, which comes for 30,000. The other variant available in the market is 128GB with 8GB of RAM for 28,000 and 64GB with 6GB of RAM, which will come later in September for 25,000. Let's quickly open the box. Here's the handset, keeping it aside for now. First, we'll see what else we have in here. A welcome letter. Then you get a TPU with thick envelope inside, in which you get usual paperwork and OnePlus sticker and a SIM ejector tool. Everything on a side. Further, we get 30W charge. And lastly, Type A to Type C typical OnePlus charging cable. Now back to the handset. Nord is the cheapest 5G phone in India currently, though 5G is yet to launch in India. Let me remove the sticker. Nord comes in two colors, blue marble and grey onyx. We have a blue variant. The handset looks really good, not oversized, but still we get huge display of 6.44 inches fluid AMOLED display with Gorilla Glass 5 protection on both the sides. It weighs 184 grams. Let me tell you, a good weight distribution has been done by OnePlus. Let's take a quick physical overview. On the top, we have just a secondary microphone. On the side, we have an alert slider and a power button. On the bottom, we have a single speaker, not stereo, Type-C USB, primary microphone and a SIM card tray. Let's remove and see. Currently supports dual 4G SIM cards or a single 5G SIM. 5G plus 4G support will be made available via OT update in the future. There is this rubber ring on the SIM card tray, which makes it water resistant. Though the OnePlus Nord is not having an IP rating, but it has P2I coating, which makes the phone splash resistant. Nord doesn't even have 3.5mm headphone jack. This is a big disappointment. Well, now on the left, we only have volume rockers. On the back, we have a quad camera setup where the top cam is of 8MP for ultra wide with 119 degrees FOV. Second one is 48MP main camera with optical image stabilization plus electronic image stabilization. Third one is 5MP depth sensor. And fourth is just 2MP macro shooter, which I think is way too less and could have been more. Coming in front, we have a dual camera setup looking like a capsule with 32MP Sony IMX616 sensor and an 8MP for ultra wide, which adds depth to the selfies and gives wider images up to 105 degrees. TPU case cover looks of a good quality. Let me remove the stickers. Looks cool on the phone with good camera cuts and USB jack protection cover. Well, the corners are also well protected, as you can see. And if you haven't noticed, OnePlus gives a screen guard pre-applied. That's a good thing. OnePlus Nord comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 765G SoC, built with 7 nanometers process with integrated Adreno 620 GPU. This combination is both powerful processing and power efficient as well. Adaptive brightness works well in direct sunlight or in dark. The screen has a good visibility. This has NFC also. Let's check out the about phone in the settings. We get Android 10 plus OnePlus Oxygen OS 10.5. Let's see the storage in this. It says 29GB used after my normal app installation. Nord has a 4115mAh battery, which is not much, can go only for one day for a heavy user. But we have a 30W quick charger, which charges 0 to 70% in just half an hour. Talking about the network and call quality, it gives a good call quality. If we see the SAR value, for the head it is 1.08 and for the body 0.78, that's good. Let's check the fingerprint scanner. As you can see, it is very fast as it has optical fingerprint scanner. Same goes with the face recognition, it is fast as well. Let's quickly check the camera. Camera quality is very good. Micro shots are far better in 2x. Camera quality is very much similar to that of OnePlus 8. Colors look vibrant. The 5 megapixel depth shooter does its job quite well. I'll try to catch some shots outdoor and post sample shots at the end of this video. Now let's test the speaker loudness of the single speaker. I'll play my recent video.
Seems like Samsung is trying its hand in budget smartphones with usual paperwork. Remember, they are not pro at mic. You can see it is very fast. Not the fastest like Samsung models, but not the fastest considering other models in the market.
As you can hear, the speaker is quite loud and clear. It is Widevine L1 certified. So one can stream Netflix and various OTT platform videos in HD quality. Now coming to the gaming, chipset Snapdragon 765G with 7 nanometers and 90Hz of refresh rate. High-end games like PUBG, Call of Duty run smoothly without any stumbling. However, PUBG was restricted only to HD graphics, but still on 60fps the gaming experience was smooth. So this is all for now. If you are looking for a mid-range smartphone with a performance and great looks, OnePlus Nord is a great choice. Hope you like this video. If yes, please click on the like button below this video and don't forget to subscribe to Your Super User for more such videos. Bye bye for now and I'll see you in the next one.